this video, Jessica will be telling everything about School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada. Hi, Jessica. Welcome to my channel.
Hello.
And the first question from you is that tell our viewers something about you and how you end up in architecture, your full journey and your full experience in architecture.
Okay, so I mean, if I start about myself, I'm Jessica, as you already mentioned. And I'm in SPA Vijayawada. I'm from Delhi and I am currently in third year and would be in fourth year in a month. So like my journey into architecture began when I was in ninth grade, and you know, I like most architecture students before they join architecture, I was very good into, like, you know, I was into sketching and doodling and all of that. And I got to learn that there is a course where I could, you know, make a degree out of doodling and making models. So yeah, that's how I got inspired. But you know, it's way more complex than that in real life. So yeah, there is that. And I mean, the main reason why I actually love architecture was because it's a creative field.
So the next question from Jessica is that was your experience in School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada. So SPA being the College of National Importance, so what is your whole experience of doing architecture from SPA Vijayawada?
If I talk about my experience in SPA Vijayawada, I personally feel that, you know, everything is very sorted in the Department of Architecture alone. So like our faculties, they're the best in their fields, and you know, they're very, very like experienced people, so we get to learn a lot from them. I mean, obviously, because they're such learned people. And on top of that, like most design colleges, we have, you know, studio systems, so we get to learn a lot from each other as classmates. And through our seniors also, owing to the fact that we all live on campus in hostels. So there's a lot of interactive and competitive, cooperative kind of, you know, learning happening. And we develop skills which are, you know, outside of the architecture world also. So we get to learn a lot in a lot of aspects in SPA Vijayawada.
And I also want to know about the procedure, how you can get into SPA Vijayawada. So our viewer are mostly like, they want to know ki kaun sa entrance examination dena hota hai for School of Planning and Architecture Vijayawada, or like rank kitni chahiye hoti hai. So can you tell this examination or cutoff kitna roughly chahiye hota hai for getting admission in SPA Vijayawada?
Okay, so if you want to get into SPA Vijayawada, you would need to clear JEE Mains Paper 2, which is like for architecture. And the rank, basically, it is, you know, it changes every year, so it's not constant. But the year that I got into SPA Vijayawada, the cutoff went up to 1200 something rank. So I mean, it changes every year. The next year it was 1500, and like so on, it kept changing. So that is relative to the, you know, the competition on in that particular year. But if we talk about the number of seats in our college, mostly our batches in architecture department, we have every batch has almost approximately 80 people. So there is that.
So the next question from Jessica is that, like, what is the perks of doing architecture from SPA Vijayawada? So national importance ka college hai, so obviously kuch to perks honge. And please discuss those perks with us, ki kya kya fayde hote hain, kya kya important, like pros mil jate hain if you study in School of Planning and Architecture Vijayawada.
So if I start talking about the perks of being in SPA Vijayawada, I mean, matlab main to yahi hai ki hamara campus is a new campus. So there's a lot to learn from the building itself. I mean, it's an amazing building which has been featured in many international architectural magazines. And there's a lot to learn from, I mean, first year to third year, we've been learning a lot of things. Like in first year, we learned principles of design through it. And now we're learning about services through it. I mean, it's a whole journey in itself, the whole building. It's amazing. The architecture is amazing. Secondly, since it's a new campus, everything, like the infrastructure-wise, everything was taken into consideration. We have different labs, I mean, to, you know, have a better understanding of our subjects. Like, we have a construction lab, art lab, and, you know, other things we can utilize as we have our normal classes to have a better understanding. Moreover, I mean, being in an SPA, in any SPA, there's a lot of exposure. जो भी इफ यू टॉक टू बाहर के लोग जो भी होगा वो यही बोलेगा कि मतलब यू नो यू आर फ्रॉम एन एसपीए आई मीन यू डोंट रियली नीड टू हैव एनी एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर बिकॉज द यू नो नेम इनफ इज ऑलरेडी लाइक इफ यू अप्लाई फॉर वर्क आउटसाइड आई मीन इफ यू हैव अ गुड इनफ पोर्टफोलियो
सो आई विल से दैट देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ नेम एंड like name also come with responsibility. So portfolio obviously jo surrounding ke student hote hain unko dekh dekh ke itna acha ho jata hai because you see a lot of people who are also working with you. I think that is the reason ki ha kuch applicable hota hai ye sari cheeze. But if your work is not good, if you are in a SPA, then tab to problem hai. I will say matlab work will be the most important thing for any college. SPA helps to get that work and get that quality of work.
Since people from all across India, from all different states come into this college and, you know, they bring in a lot of their own cultures and different vibe to them and sab kyunki cream hai matlab India ki, they are like top AIR rankers. So we get to learn a lot from them and we, I mean, it's a whole, you know, interactive learning process which really owes to the level of work that we do.
So the next question from you is that, what is the fee structure of School of Planning and Architecture Vijayawada? So it's being a government college, what is the fees that we can expect and what are the some reservations that are related to the college?
If we talk about the fee structure, generally, like mostly almost 90% population in our college, we all live in hostels. So if we talk about the hostel and mess fee included in our yearly fees, it is from, I think, 60 to it ranges from 60 to 80,000 per year. And I mean, there is also like, you know, since COVID happened. So if I talk about the numbers from last year, in for first year, if I say it was, I think, around 65,000, the fee structure. And if anybody really needs to inquire about the fee structure, about, you know, for different categories and all of that, or for, you know, international students, they can just refer it on our website, spav.ac.in, and everything is provided there in the fee and payment section.
So Jessica, can you present your portfolio with our viewers? Because portfolio se kafi help milega ki college mein kaise kaam hota hai aur portfolio किस टाइप का बनता है आर्किटेक्चर में, सो अप टू यू.
ओके, सो आई डोंट हैव मच, बट आई कैन शेयर माय लास्ट सेमेस्टर्स प्रोजेक्ट विद यू. इट वाज बेसिकली अ हेरिटेज इंटरप्रिटेशन सेंटर व्हिच आई मेड इन दिल्ली. दिस वाज माय सिक्स्थ सेमेस्टर, यू नो, आर्किटेक्चरल डिजाइन प्रोजेक्ट. एंड व्हाट वी वर सपोज टू डू वाज वी वर सपोज टू डिजाइन अ हेरिटेज इंटरप्रिटेशन सेंटर in heritage context, basically, you know, cities with very rich heritage. So I picked Delhi for my project, and before hum koi project start kare, we do a detailed study of the context and everything and whatever we are supposed to design. So this is that, and I mean, I made a whole timeline of the different eras in Delhi, under different rulers, and the different styles of architecture and different elements that came in with the different styles and under different rulers, actually, in different dynasties that were there in Delhi, or jo building typologies hoti thi, or matlab architectural character hota tha wahan ka, like I did a whole study about that. We do case studies, matlab jo existing projects hai, like, you know, jo hamara jo actual project hai उसके जैसे So we studied those, and for that I took one case study in Delhi, two case studies I took in Delhi, and one of them was an international case study, and all three of them resonated with what I was actually going to design. So I did a comparative analysis of the three and, you know, came up with some interpretation of my own so I could use it in my design. Then what we do is we pick a site. I picked a site in Bikaji Kama place in Delhi, and I studied about the context of that site and, you know, the whole how much traffic comes there, like the population demographics and what climate happens there, and jo bhi wahan ka context hai, contextual study or important heritage sites jo bhi wahan pe thi, everything about that. So this is all of that. And if we talk next, my concept basically was to, you know, have a interpretation center that reflected the heritage but was still, you know, modern and minimal at the same time. So yeah, basically these are some of the diagrams that, you know, show how the form developed and different spaces came in, like the, you know, main exhibition hall, the stalls there, I mean different blocks, how they came in and all of that. And then this is my design process, in which, you know, I have shown how I tried to have a more modern yet heritage like structure for my design basically. So the next thing we do while we design is, you know, mainly our site plan, and we show everything that we have in the site and an overview of the whole thing. So this is that, and yeah, so basically these are all the different spaces I have mentioned on the right panel of this sheet, all the different spaces that exist in my design. So yes, and then this is all about how this functions and how people circulate through it, how the vehicles come in and the different pedestrians come in through different entries, and how the circulation happens to have a, you know, a wholesome experience into the whole complex of this, you know, heritage interpretation center. And then there's so basically this is that. I have done zoning of different blocks of the complex, which are the food court, craft bazaar and exhibition centers, libraries and workshops and all of that. So next thing, I have detailed out all the different blocks in my design, and this is basically a craft bazaar with exploded isometric view, a 3D, you know, exploded view, so to have a better picture of what the stall really looks like with the plan and the section of it and the different materials that I use for making that block. And then this is the main exhibition hall with all its floor plans and, you know, cloisters on the sides of it, elements from jo bhi hamara heritage wala humne study kiya tha starting mein, taking elements from those dome and jali walls and all that Islamic elements. I made this up, and then these are some sections and elevations of the same and some views from the inside. And this is the food court, basically also having some of the elements from heritage, like jali walls and, I mean, the basic stuff generally. So this is a workshop shed where they could conduct workshops in an interpretation center, where, you know, to get more connected to heritage in an interpretation center. So this is that. And then here are some, you know, 3D visualization, proper views of how it's gonna look like when it's built. So this is all about my design in a nutshell.
Jessica, it was a really nice portfolio, and it, according to third year, it's a craft museum with a lot of interesting things happening in the design. And once again, thank you so much. And after watching this video, people will be more clear about School of Planning and Architecture Vijayawada. especially Department of Architecture. So thank you so much for joining us, and thank you so much, Jessica, for joining the, for telling a lot about SPA Vijayawada in this video.
Thanks for calling me.